Since this video is going up on Juneteenth, it seemed like the perfect time to talk about the intersections of artificial intelligence and race, specifically as it applies to Black people. This isn't the first time that I've talked about issues relating to fairness, bias, or racism in artificial intelligence or algorithms more generally, but I thought it would be useful to do a video on the relationship between systems, algorithms, and race, because while race-based bias is a serious problem in artificial intelligence, AI is but one modern tool that's being used to propagate systems that have been around for years, if not centuries. I'm going to touch on some broad topics, which I'll put up here, but doing any of these topics justice in and of themselves would require their own separate videos, so if you would like for me to do a separate video on any one of these topics, you can let me know in the comments. Also, a lot of you are new here, so if this is the first video of mine that you've seen, hi, I'm Jordan. I'm a PhD student who loves learning about the ways that we interact with artificial intelligence and algorithms on a day-to-day basis. Consider subscribing if you want to learn more, and you can follow me on Twitter for more of my PhD life. So I started this video by saying that it was timely given that it was coming out on Juneteenth. For anyone who doesn't know, Juneteenth is a holiday celebrating the liberation of slaves in America. It refers to June 19th, 1865, which was the day that federal orders proclaiming that all slaves in the state of Texas were now free were read by Union General Gordon Granger in Galveston, Texas. This proclamation was actually the Emancipation Proclamation, which had made slavery illegal in the Confederate states about 3 years earlier. However, because Texas was the most remote slave state at the time, there wasn't a huge Union Army presence there, and they didn't have the internet to convey the news, it took a while for the proclamation to get over to Texas and actually be enforced. Now, obviously systemic racism did not end with the Emancipation Proclamation and continues to be an issue in the United States now. And I'm saying systemic racism instead of racism for a reason. Systemic racism, also called institutional racism or structural racism, is defined as discrimination expressed through social and political institutions. So systems like the criminal justice system, the healthcare system, the employment system, and more. This is different from just racism, which is typically defined as the belief that race determines certain human traits and capacities that result in an inherent superiority of one race over another. In other words, racism usually refers to individual belief, whereas systemic racism usually refers to the impact of institutions designed and shaped by those beliefs. I'll say now that some systemic racism is intentional, that is, the people who are designing these systems know that it will negatively and disproportionately impact people of color, in this case Black people, and some of them are either unintentional or a lot more nuanced. Issues in artificial intelligence tend to fall into that latter category. Okay, so we finally got into the AI part of the video. So as systems evolve, they take new form based on the needs of the system as well as the resources available at the time. This is often driven by things like increased efficiency. Right now, AI is one of those resources that can be used to re-implement existing systems. And this is all to say that, as I've mentioned in earlier videos as well as in this one, a lot of the fairness and bias issues that we talk about when it comes to artificial intelligence are not AI problems. That is, they weren't created when we developed these tools. In fact, they often stem from the fact that the data that we use reflects history. It reflects the tools that we used to use to build these systems, and it reflects the beliefs and power structures of the people who shape those systems. And with that data comes bias. However, compared to earlier tools, there are a few things that make AI and algorithms different. First, they're hidden from view. In the past, interacting with most of these systems, from housing to employment to healthcare, required you to go and interact with a person in some capacity, whether it be in person or over the phone. Now, a lot of these algorithms do that same work behind the scenes, to the point where you may not actually know that there's an algorithm making that decision. Second, it's very hard to ask algorithms questions. Explainability in AI continues to be an active area of research, and they've come up with new tools that help us probe models to better understand how they make decisions. However, for the average person interacting with an algorithm, there's no real way to ask the algorithm why it made the decision that it did. As a quick aside, there's also some debate in the field over whether explainability is something that we should be striving for in the first place, because algorithms don't think or decide in the same way that humans do. In fact, they don't think or decide at all. So the answers that we get when we ask models these questions may not actually be useful or even intelligible. Third, algorithms amplify patterns in your datasets. Many, many studies have shown that machine learning models amplify the patterns that already exist in the datasets they are trained on. And fourth, the negative impact of algorithms is often unintentional, either through side effects or because the outcome contradicts the initial intent of the model. We'll talk about this in a few of the examples, but this is actually more of a human problem than an AI problem. Generally speaking, algorithms solve the problems that we ask them to. The challenge is making sure the problem that you're asking your model to solve is actually the problem that you would like to have solved. It seems like it would be easy, but in practice, it's quite challenging. I know a lot of this is abstract, so now I want to go through a few examples of systemic racism that existed well before computing became a popular thing, and how those systems have been codified through artificial intelligence and algorithms. We'll start with credit and lending systems, which we actually talked about a few months ago when reporting broke that the Apple Card seemed to be discriminating against women, either by giving them lower credit limits or by denying the application entirely, even though they had comparable financial histories to men who were approved for the card and given higher limits. As we discussed in that video, the banking system has a long history of discriminating against anyone who isn't a white man when it comes to credit and loans, and that definitely includes the Black community. And that discrimination used to be more explicit, exemplified through things like redlining, where banks would refuse to invest in minority communities, claiming that they were more high risk. The Equal Credit Opportunity Act of 1974 was designed to prevent discrimination on the basis of being a member of a protected class, and it was actually hoped that the introduction of algorithmic decision-making into credit and loan decisions would make the process fairer. In fact, researchers at UC Berkeley conducted a study in 2018 showing that Black and Latinx borrowers were charged mortgage interest rates roughly 6-9% higher than white borrowers by both face-to-face lenders and lending algorithms, even though they had equivalent financial histories. In a kind of good news, that same study showed that lending algorithms also discriminate against Black and Latinx borrowers by charging them higher interest rates, but that the rates that the algorithms charge are 40% less than those of human lenders. So that's good. Another issue we've discussed extensively is the issue of facial recognition, especially as it applies to policing and law enforcement. As we discussed in my Crash Course in Facial Recognition video, racial bias in photography existed long before facial recognition. Cameras were designed to complement white skin and were also generally expensive, so there weren't that many photos taken of Black people, and the ones that were taken came out bad. This contributed to the issue of facial recognition bias against darker skin tones because in these data sets we don't have enough high quality images of people with darker skin tones, and so the model can't learn to recognize them. When used in law enforcement, this can result in inaccurate identifications of people of color, leading to accusations or worse, convictions for crimes that someone didn't commit. It can also amplify the existing issues of racial profiling, a long history of overpolicing Black communities, and the more recent documented bias against Black people of the algorithms being used to determine how likely you are to reoffend at trial. Finally, we will wrap up with an example from the healthcare system. In a recent example, a study showed that an algorithm that is widely used in the US healthcare system was less likely to refer Black patients with complex needs to treatment programs that aim to improve their care when compared to equally sick white people. The algorithm in question made these decisions by assigning risk scores to patients, which were in part based on the amount that they had spent on healthcare costs in the last year. The assumption is that spending less money on healthcare means that you are a healthier person because you haven't had to spend as much money on healthcare. The algorithm would then refer higher-risk patients to these personalized treatment programs. The study showed that, on average, patients who identified as Black were assigned lower risk scores than patients who identified as white. However, the study also showed that patients who identify as Black were, on average, much sicker than patients who identify as white. So, what gives? Well, due to a history of reduced access to medical care for reasons ranging from distrust of the medical system to lack of physical or financial access to explicit racism from healthcare providers, Black people on average spend less money on healthcare. In fact, a 2005 study from the National Academy of Medicine revealed that even if you control for insurance status, income, age, and severity of medical conditions, Black people receive lower quality of care, are disproportionately sicker, and have shorter lifespan than white people. So in the case of this study, it wasn't that the Black patients weren't as sick as the white patients were, it's that Black people historically don't spend as much money on healthcare as white people do. In fact, the study revealed that only 17.7% of patients referred to the personalized treatment plans were Black, reinforcing this disparity, and that number would increase to 46.5% if the algorithm was unbiased. So I'll leave you with those examples. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, this is only the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the intersection of artificial intelligence and race, so if you'd like to see more videos on that, you can let me know in the comments. I've also included some additional resources if you'd like to read up on that topic on your own, as well as some resources if you would like to learn about Black history. Especially if you live in the United States, I've always found it a little bit odd that we teach Black history as this thing that is separate from the rest of American history, when it is in fact so central to the evolution of our country over 400 years. So you can check those out if you're interested, and you can check out more videos that I've done that touch on this topic up here, and I will see you guys next Friday. Bye!